Good morning, students. So in today's class, we're going to see propionic acid fermentation. Now, before we commence it, I request you all to take a pen and paper because the points which I'm going to tell you all is not there in your handouts. So please take a pen and paper and make a note of it. Propionic acid is produced by several anaerobic bacteria. Propionic acid is produced by several anaerobic bacteria, among which some of the prominent bacteria are as follows. In case you get a 2 marks question, you can write it. There's no big mention of it in the handout, so I'm dictating it. Please make a note. So the first one is Corniform Propionibacterium. You can see the spelling is mentioned on the board. Corniform Propionibacterium. This is one. Due to lack of space on the board, I couldn't make a note of others. I will dictate. You please make a note. Corniform, Corniform Corniform Propionibacterium. Propionibacterium, comma, Velonella, 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 I repeat it, Velonella, comma, Clostridium, 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 comma, Selenomonas, Selenomonas, full stop. So I've given you 4 examples here. Next point, make a note. Propionibacterium acidopropionaceae. Propionibacterium acidopropionaceae. The spelling is written here. Propionibacterium acidopropionaceae and Propionibacterium fruit enrichi. Are the main propionic acid fermenters. Full stop. Propionibacterium possess cytochromes and catalase, cytochrome, cytochromes, cytochromes. Propionibacteria possess cytochromes and catalase, catalase, and catalase, and can tolerate some amount of oxygen, full stop. They are natural inhabitants of rumen, R-U-M-E-N. They are natural inhabitants of rumen of herbivorous cattle. Okay, so these points are missing in your handout. Please make a note, add them to your handout and write it in the exam in case you get this question. So now we're going into the pathway. So this was the introduction, which microorganisms help in fermentation of propionic acid. So propionic acid is also an anaerobic pathway. Okay, keep in mind. So now we're entering into the pathway. Now what we get to see here, once again the precursor is glucose. Okay, glucose with the help of glycolytic pathway is giving rise to pyruvic acid. Okay, now So I have written the entire glycolytic pathway in blue color. Glucose to pyruvate is glycolytic pathway. It is in blue color. Okay. Now this pyruvic acid further in presence of pyruvic carboxylase is giving rise to oxaloacetic acid. Please listen with your open ears. Now oxaloacetic acid again in presence of malic acid dehydrogenase giving rise to malic acid giving rise to fumaric acid to succinic acid to succinyl-CoA. Where did you listen or read about all these intermediates? If you can recollect, try to recollect what we have read in the metabolic pathways in your TCA cycle, in tricarboxylic acid cycle or in Krebs cycle, we heard about these intermediates. What did we see? Oxaloacetic acid. Next, after oxaloacetic acid, we had malic acid. So this is written in reverse order, reversal of TCA cycle. Oxaloacetic acid, malic acid, fumaric acid, succinic acid, succinyl-CoA. In general, how does it come? Citrate, isocitrate, alpha-ketoglutarate, succinate, succinyl-CoA, succinic acid, fumaric acid, malic acid, oxaloacetic acid. Once again, it combines with acetyl-CoA, citrate to give isocitrate. Did you remember? Do you remember the entire TCA cycle? How your TCA cycle is functioning? So here the intermediates which I have written in black color, all these are intermediates of TCA cycle. Okay. It is reversal of TCA cycle. In TCA cycle, we go like this, in this direction. Succinyl-CoA gives rise to succinic acid, fumaric acid, malic acid and oxalic acid. But here it is reversal. Ulta we are coming. Oxaloacetic acid giving rise to malic acid, fumaric acid, succinic acid and succinyl-CoA. So these black colored reactions are intermediates of TCA cycle. This succinyl-CoA in presence of methyl malonyl mutase enzyme, which is a vitamin B12 linked enzyme, is giving rise to methyl malonyl-CoA. Right? So this is not a compound of TCA cycle, hence it is not written in black color. Okay? Methyl malonyl-CoA in presence of carboxylase enzyme with removal of one molecule of carbon dioxide is giving rise to propionyl-CoA. Propionyl-CoA with the loss of one CoA molecule is giving rise to propionic acid. Right? Now this is a compound which we require. To produce this compound, these are the two bacteria which is most commonly used. Propionibacterium acidopropionici and Propionibacterium fluid enrichi. These two microorganisms are useful in production of propionic acid in anaerobic fermentation. Right? Now, other important thing, you could see this acetate which I have written here. Acetate is written in red color. So, it is nothing but acetate is also a byproduct which is released from pyruvic acid. So, from the entire propionic acid fermentation, we are having two products formed. One is propionic acid, the other one is acetate. Our main aim is production of propionic acid. But apart from propionic acid, acetate is another byproduct which is formed. Okay, so actually pyruvic acid gives rise to acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA then gives rise to, with the loss of one CoA molecule, it gives rise to acetyl phosphate. And then acetyl phosphate gives rise to acetate. So from pyruvic acid, one byproduct, acetate is also formed. So propionic acid fermentation releases two products. One is acetate, other one is propionic acid. Acetate is formed from pyruvic acid. Okay, coming to the energetics. Energetics of propionic acid fermentation. Now here, because it is anaerobic condition, absence of oxygen, nowhere our NADH is taken into account, right? So we are only concerned with ATP. We know in glycolytic pathway, under anaerobic condition, two ATPs are released, right? Under aerobic conditions, eight were released. Under anaerobic, in absence of oxygen, two ATPs are released. So two ATPs from glycolysis, and from here to ATPs from TCA cycle. If you can remember, there is one production of GTP molecule. GTP is also giving, GTP is nothing but ATP. So from TCA cycle to ATPs and from glycolysis to ATPs. Okay, so ultimately four ATPs are released. So for every breakdown of one molecule of glucose, 4 ATPs are released in propionic acid fermentation. Energetics of propionic acid fermentation from glucose is 4 ATP molecules. Is it clear? Okay, everything is fine. I hope you have understood everything. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Thank you.